South Africa will be transferred to a country of all South Africans, of all races and creeds. That is inescapable.
What's happening during the 60s was that the repression was so intensive that the enemy dictated conditions of silence. People didn't say anything and they avoided doing anything, but they were waiting because in the early 60s, cadres left the country for military training. So the people were waiting. Well, the ceiling of repression was broken in the early 70s, in part as a result of the actions by the ANC, for example, the clashes in what was then Rhodesia, in Wanki, where the ANC was involved together with Zimbabwean liberation forces. That opened the gates. And the people began to come out more boldly. This was 1967, 68. So during the early 70s, there was a growing buildup even within South Africa because people had become more defiant. The enemy could not contain the determination of the people anymore. And so then you then began to get the mood of resistance and defiance, which the ANC had inculcated during the 50s. The news of the massacre stunned and shocked us and angered us greatly. It was something we could least have expected after the experience of Sharpeville. In Sharpeville, it was a tremendous shock to our people. 1976 caught us unprepared. We were still building up on mass mobilization and building up on our armed struggle. But we found ourselves unable to respond to this brutality. After that, the struggle was at a new level, and we had to quickly adjust to that new level. Young people were coming out by the hundred for military training. We didn't have the facilities to handle so many at the time, but we had to organize ourselves and provide training. Yet others were really too young to be military trained. There was another area of training that our people needed, and that was academic. And so we began to conceive of the idea of establishing a school to take in the young people who had been forced out of school. That is how we developed what was later to become the Solomon Mahlangu Freedom College.
On this occasion, the world is with us in support, guaranteeing that we shall win. Amanda!